Hey guys, welcome back to the next video, and this time it's a brand new Aio from PCCOOLER, the DC360 PRO ARGB DISPLAY. It has a little tiny screen. Okay, so this is another Aio from PCCOOLER. This is the DC360. This does have a digital, a LCD display on it, which can be displayed the temperatures and so forth. So just get this open. Now, what I will say is about PCCOOLER, I do like the way they package their AIOs. It's very good quality form and such, so it won't, so it will get to you fine. So let's have a look. Now, they do it a bit unconventional. They do it on the side, which is weird to me, but I mean, this is the only brand that actually does it on the side. A lot of them do it on the pull way, where you pull it from this, yeah, that way. So see, good form. So put this away now. But there. Okay, so the included accessories. Okay, so this does support AM4 and AM5. It does support LGA 1700. I'm assuming this will support the new 18 Ultra series from Intel, because this is brand new, this haven't long come out. So have a look at the AIO. Yep, fans are pre-installed, so that is fantastic. So let's go with this. Okay, so it's the white version. Nice, always looks nice in white. I like, nice, that looks nice. At that, I do like white products for some reason. I don't know why, I just do. Does this come off? No. Oh, look, it's already got pre-installed this looks like Intel bracketry, so that is will be a that's a 3-pin. Please stop using 3-pin in 2025. PCCOOLER, you need to use 4-pin for the pump. Please don't. It's 2025. We need to get away from DC 3-pin. Then that is the connector for the USB. That'll be to control the screen. Now, the fans, they are a proprietary cable. But I'm giving too much... I'm going a bit too off tangent with brands because of proprietary cables. But what I'm going to say is this is a very standard cable. Thermalright uses it. So I'm assuming this would be easy to find, but still you shouldn't have to worry about a cable breaking and not being able to find it. But it does go to 3-pin PWM, 3-pin ARGB and 4-pin PWM. The fans, and of course they're white, these are exactly the same as the black ones they got. So let's have a look at the overall spec, shall we? So radiate dimensions, of course this is the 360, so yes. The water block dimensions is 82 for length, width is 69, nice, and the height is 65. So the tube length is 400 millimeters. It's a ceramic bearing. The pump speed is 2600 RPM with a noise decibel rating of 15 decibels. And of course the connectors are DC 3-pin, unfortunately. The fans included, of course, does come with three. They are 120 fans. They do have fluid dynamic bearings. The rated speed and RPM is 500, between 500 and 2500 RPM. The airflow, though, is 90.56 CFM. Probably the highest rating I've actually had for an AIO. The start pressure is a 4.07 H. Millimeter H2O, that's probably one of the highest I've actually seen. Now, the decibel rating is at 39.8 decibels. That's loud. 4-pin PWM, it's a 12 volt DC. The amperage is a 0.35A ARGB. It's a lightning connector, which is a 5 volt 3-pin. And then, of course, then the panel type here is IPS. And the actual size is a 2.4 inch with a resolution at 240 times 320, so it's not a big screen, but it's a screen nonetheless. So let's get this on the test bench. Okay, so this is the new DC360 from PCCOOLER. I'm going to put the mic up towards the fans at 50% fan speed. I mean, at 50%, there is a little bit of a noise, but it isn't really bad. Same thing, but 100% fan speed. Well, that is very loud. Okay, so as for the test system, it's my normal test bench. It's a Ryzen 9 5900X with PBO enabled, so you get the best done, so it pushes it. It's got 16 gigs of DDR4, it's got X570 platform, it's got a RX 7600XT, and it's housed in the Shadow Base 800FX from Be Quiet. Now, as for room temperature, the room temperature at before testing was 8 Celsius, but did go up to 10 after testing. So, for this will be for 50% fan speed, and for CPU power, it was high at 204 watts, but did go down to 187. CPU clocks, high 4.9 and low 4.4. Well above base clocks, so I'm going to worry about that. So, as a Cinebench R23, the idles were 25 with a max of 72. Blender Pavilion, idles 25 with a max of 71. Blender Classroom, idles 25 with a max of 70. And 3D Marks Test, idles 25 with a max of 66 Celsius. Now, as for 100% fan speed, the CPU power was exactly the same. At high was 204 watts, but the lows was a lot higher this time. It only went down to 193. And for the CPU clocks, it was 4.9 at the start of the test, but did go down to 4.4. So it didn't lose any performance there, and this will show it. Now, as for Cinebench R23, the idles were 21 Celsius. Yes, that's correct. I measured it at 21 Celsius through hardware info. And yes, that means leaving everything off and just leaving it sit there or idle. The max of Cinebench R23 was 71. Blender Pavilion idle 21 with a max of 68. Blender Classroom idles 21 with a max of 67. And 3D Mark CPTS idles 21 with a max of 70 Celsius. Now, what I'm going to do here is put up a graph showing you how this compares to other AIOs. Well, let me just tell you that this stomps all over all of them. Now, I have run these tests 3 times, and yes, the temperatures are correct. These are the lowest, one of the lowest temperatures I've had with an AIO before. So I will put this in a graph against like Thermalright, Be Quiet, and other brands out there. Okay, so as for the software, what I'm going to do here is put up a walkthrough video. Now, the software is very basic and it's very easy to use. You can upload GIFs, you can change the overall information as well, and you can also put custom lettering and so forth. You can put your own custom GIFs and GIFs or whatever, however you pronounce it, but that you can do that as well. It's very easy to install as well. What I will do is I will leave the link for the installation for this particular one down below in the description. So if you're looking for this one, I will leave the link down below, and installation is quite easy. Now, that's the software done. And very, like I said, very easy to use. Now, as for the things that I've already said to PCCOOLER before the review went live, is my little niggles and the things that I think they need to change. Now, one will be the USB 2.0 cable. This cable is what comes off the display. This is how the software controls the display. It's exactly the same cable that Thermalright and other AIO brands use. So what the problem? Well, the cable isn't long enough to accommodate bigger cases. So if you were to go with this case and you didn't have the enough length on the cable, then you'd have to run it down through the graphics card, which I had to on here, if you saw through the B-roll, which unfortunately does make your system look ugly. It doesn't affect anything in terms of the display or anything, but I think they need to just make it a bit longer to accommodate bigger cases, so that at least then it wouldn't look so ugly. But the other one is also the pump header. Now, what I have also mentioned to them is they need to go from 3-pin DC to 4-pin PWM, which is fully controllable. So, because that is something that all brands are going down, it's the path a lot of all majority of brands I work with are going down. 4-pin PWM for the pump speed. So that's something that PCCOOLER needs to realize. Yes, it's probably, I've seen it more over here, maybe not so much over in Asia and over there, but if they do it, and they probably, you know, it'll definitely make the overall experience of using a product from them much easier. Now, as for the installation, the performance, the thermals are fantastic. I think it's down to this, which is a bracket that goes on it. Now, as for installation, yes, it is that, basically. All you do is hold the back plate, make sure this is on there correctly, and just try to hold the back plate while you tighten it down. Now, because this has got 4 points of contact, that's where I think the low thermals and the low idles have come from. Because four point of contact is much better than 2 points. Now, yes, you can have a problem sometimes where you tighten it down one side and don't tighten enough down the other, and the thermal paste kind of squishes out. But as long as you tighten it properly, evenly, each side, go from that side to that side to that side to that side, you will be fine. And to be honest, that's a better mechanism than most. Now, if you want to buy it, I don't actually know that it's actually not available in the UK at the moment. So what I will do is leave a link down to PCCOOLER website so you guys can find out where in Asia or the US or wherever else they sell it, if you want to buy it, because it's a nice looking AIO, and quite honestly, it's their first one. So as for other products, they do have another one with a bigger screen. That one I have already requested. I've got a air cooler by here, which is a new one. And that's pretty much everything I've got, except for everything I've got coming. That's monitors, more air coolers, AIOs, cases. I've got loads. So make sure you subscribe. And as always, I hope you guys have a fantastic week and weekend ahead of you. This is Richard for Welsh Tech. Goodbye.